Thank you. Family and friends, we are gathered together today in the presence of God and of this company, that Colby Criscitello and Maria Tallo may be united in holy matrimony. We celebrate this glorious act that God is about to perform, the act of converting their love for one another into the holy, sacred estate of marriage. The union of husband and wife is intended by God for your mutual joy, for help and comfort in times of adversity and prosperity, and when it's God's will, for the procreation of children and raising them in the nurture and knowledge of the Lord. Therefore, marriage should not be entered unadvisedly or lightly, but soberly, purposefully, and certainly joyfully. And we're joyful today. It's amazing how this moment, God can do so much powerful. He does so many powerful things right here and now. It's amazing. Even at this moment, we're about to witness one of his supernatural acts in the midst of marriage, the transference of leadership and responsibility from a father to a new son. Colby, headship will rest on you. Leadership rests on you. Lead carefully. Lead responsibly. Lead full of grace, full of joy, full of love. Lead with your eyes fixed on Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith, who promises to faithfully lead you wherever you walk and wherever you go. and promises also to be your closest companion, both of you. No matter how many mountaintops you walk on and how many valleys are in between, He is there for both of you. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for this glorious, wonderful, beautiful day. Lord, thank you for Colby and Maria, Lord, who stand here today before their friends and family, but ultimately before you to say, Lord, here we are. Lord, would you do a miracle of marriage today? Lord, uniting these hearts together. Father, I pray, Lord, that you'd build them on the foundation of your word and your purpose and your life. Strengthen them in everything they do and everywhere they walk, wherever the roads may lead them, we pray. In Jesus' name. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Good evening, everyone. Wow. Anyone else deaf? Pastor Ben, thank you, brother. Pastor Ben has been the pastor of the Criscitello family for about 100 years. He's a great man. Thank you all for coming. We so appreciate it. The first thing that's going to happen is what happened in Genesis chapter 49 when Jacob, as the patriarch to his family, spoke a blessing over all 12 of his children, and those blessings have echoed through the generations. They're still coming to pass today. So Eric and I are going to speak a blessing over our children. So this is for the two of you, but it's also for the four of us, because this blessing will extend down to our descendants through this couple. Amen. Colby and Maria, may the Lord bless you in sacrificial love for one another as you enter this journey. May He bless the work of your hands individually and corporately. And may you use the fruit of your hard work to bless others always. May you be a strength to those in need. Live in compassion for the broken and defend the defenseless, both of you. May the virtue and love of the Lord Jesus motivate you to walk in unshakable integrity and holy wisdom as true servant leaders. May you achieve your divine destinies in this life, both individually and as a couple, and may your influence as a result grow and go far and wide. May your walk with Jesus be real and open, childlike faith. May your children, our descendants, amen, brother, be like strong olive trees whose branches run over the wall and impact nations. And may your marriage bring honor to Christ, your families, your heritage, and your descendants. Amen. So I had this tender moment with my daughter upstairs, and I blessed her as we came down, and then she said, "Dad, keep it short." Really overwhelmed with her emotion. So,
say 20 minutes.
On the way down, I cut this message in half. So hopefully this will come out and make sense. All right, Genesis 2, the Lord says, a man and a woman shall enter marriage and the two shall become one. There is this oneness that's a mystery. But previously, he had given the woman to the man to complete him. And so when two people come together in marriage, they complete one another. It's not one dominating over the other. It means me without my wife, I'm totally incomplete, and she would definitely agree with me. Thank you. So that is the two becoming one, this completion, this complementing of one another. But I want to read to you from Matthew 5 in a minute. Become one, then what? Many of you are married. Then what? Why are you married? Right? I tell young people, if you're just going to marry for love, don't.
What?
The problem with it is this. If I marry for the feelings of love, if I fall in love, and that's what I'm hanging my marriage hat on, I can fall out of love when the feelings aren't there. And when you fall, it gets hurt. And so every husband and wife is called in their oneness to a common purpose. Every couple has it. Many ignore it. We don't want to here. Here's your scripture. Matthew chapter 5, Jesus said, "You, Colby and Maria, are the light of the world. You should not be hidden. People don't put a lamp under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. So let it shine." So we marry for a common purpose. Sandra and I did that. We have a passion. We're very different, but our passion has always been to prepare our children and all the spiritual children we have to serve Jesus with all their hearts and make an impact on the earth for generations to come. I'm not satisfied with just what's happening today. You look down the corridor of time. That is our common goal. We still do it. That's the work we do when we travel. That's in the next generation. And so we are as different as night and day, but we became one and found that common purpose. Colby and Maria, pretty different. You notice that, Eric? Right? So let me explain a little of the common. They both have an edge to them. Right? One of my favorite romantic movies, The Outlaw Josie Wales. Right? Clint Eastwood, he's ready to take on the bad guys, and one of his buddies says he's looking for an edge. He wants the sun at his back. These two, people don't know it. They're always looking for an edge. I like that. There's a fearlessness they both have. They both like risk and adventure. I mean, they don't really care if they fail because they're going to get after it again. They're both quick of wit and of thought. Have fun with that one, you two. But then the differences. Maria walks into a room, it's like going from 110 to 220 and your finger's in the socket. She's been like that since she was a little girl. The room gets louder. I said, "What happened here?" Well, Maria walked in. Commands the attention. It's a gift that God has given her. You want to challenge her? She's up for it. Like right up there, "Dad, keep it short." None of my other daughters did that to me. But here's the thing, Maria has no problem getting in someone's face, and I've seen her do it all of her life, but she does it with a redemptive motive to help someone through whatever they're having. But she will get in your face. Colby is a man of stealth, right? I'll be sitting there having coffee. Where did you come from? He lived with us this summer. right? Maria walks in the room, everybody knows Colby. Where is he? How did you get here? You know, he's like a ninja. There are no ninjas in the Bible. Colby will come face to face with you, but he takes a very different route. He's patient and quiet about it, and the next thing you know, he's investing in you. And this young man is becoming a son to me, and in any way he can, he will make me successful. And I've watched the two of them. They've had their disagreements, they've had their joyful moments, and I watch how they handle it. They are so different, but here's what I'm going to say to you prophetically. You are a perfect match to be that light. Your common purpose? You are massive influence of important people on this planet, because when you come together in oneness, there's a fearlessness in the two of you. And the hand of God will rest on you as long as you, young man, lead your wife in humility all the days of your lives. I mean, the sky is the limit for what the Lord wants to use you to do, both in this nation and in the world. Bless you in that, in Jesus' name. And I want to encourage all of us. If you are married, or if you're thinking of it, if you're just resting on the feeling of love, don't. Look at your marriage and say, why are we together? What can we do together to make a difference? You got that when you get married? You good with that? All right. Is that all right, Maria? A little long? Not too much. Come on up here. All right. Colby and Maria have written commitment to one another that they're going to vocalize, and then I will lead them in the covenant vow. Turn and face one another.
Check, check. Yeah. Maria, I promise to love you without conditions, and I promise to be honest and faithful without expectation. I offer you all my flaws and strengths, and I gladly take yours. I promise to honor, esteem, and hold you above all else but God for as long as I am on this earth.
Wow, that is really long.
Not a whole page, if it's short. That's why I wanted it short. Colby, have a little intro. 2.5 years ago, I felt like my life was pretty perfect. I had like the most loyal friends and the best family, and I was pursuing my dream, and nothing was going to stop me from that. And I really thought I had it all. And after meeting you, I realized that life isn't such a straight line. You just go from point A to point B to get to a destination. There's a million tiny detours when you like love someone and when you're putting them first that bring us closer together and bring us closer to God. And I never realized that someone could love me the way you do, because I don't think I've ever experienced Jesus' love in such a strong way before. And it's great because there's nothing selfish about it. It is really raw and super pure. You put people first and you serve when nobody asks. You bless your family and you fall in love with mine. And they're really tough. So,
forget that part.
So, Colby, even though you're the most compassionate, stubborn person I've ever met, I promise to always laugh at your jokes. I promise. Within reason, okay? Within reason.
You might want to put a qualifier on that.
I promise to pray for you. I promise to support your endeavors and to never stifle your passion. And though I can't promise I won't be moody or difficult, I promise to always ask forgiveness. And lastly, I promise to put you before me, and more importantly, put Jesus before me.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
culture, to love and to cherish.
She's having fun. Do you want to continue or what?
It's made it up 20 minutes.
For better or worse?
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer?
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health?
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish?
To love and to cherish.
From this day forward?
From this day forward.
Until death do us
part. Until death do us part.
Amen. Well done. The rings, please. Should be one more. Good job. Youngest and final daughter, I am marrying. This is a profound and emotional moment that I'm going to get through. Yeah. You got a good man here. If not, I'll kill him. Colby and Maria, you have exchanged sacred vows in the front of God and your family and witnesses today. You sealed it with the gift of rings. Therefore, as a minister of the gospel, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And young man, you may kiss your bride.
Christ.
Amen.
Look at I'm thankful. How about you guys?
Amen.
I'm thankful for the love that he showed. But I think we can make him happy and pleasing to him if we show him how we can love each other in this little
family.
Yes. Amen. Right.
Yeah.
Well, Lord, we pray for the food tonight, today. We ask that you bless it. And may it be sweet. The fellowship be sweet to you, Lord. In Jesus' name, we thank you. Amen.
Amen.
Great turnout. It's amazing how often they travel for free meal from the bar. You know, when it comes to a point where you find someone and you get to know them, you surely love them dearly. And for Colby, we all know that was 16 years ago when we met me. So, you look gorgeous. And I'm happy that you're marrying my
brother.
We have big, crazy families, and I'm so just excited to be part of the Talo family. And I'm going to share a story about Kobe here. So when we were younger, he saw us four twins down, us two twins down. And he had this I guess you call it a superhero. And he comes down one day with a skater, rock solid skater. And he goes, "Dad, you think it's gonna crush somebody's skull?" So he backs it on the table and he's like, "Yeah, yeah, I got it." So he's like, "Sick." He's like, I got this now, it's a weapon. And then one day he finds my dad's motocross chest protection. And he comes down to him, he's like, "Dad, punch me." So Dad obviously punches him. And he's like, okay. So, and then he makes up this superhero called Ace. And he sets us four twins down. And he says, "Riley, if I'm going to go travel to New York City, and I'm going to fight people. And if I die, you will take my place." I was fairly young, so I was like, "Really? Like, sick." So Kobe and I go way back before Fort Hayes around. I just love spending time with him. I know you're a person who's always up for doing something. Like, "Hey, you want to do it? Like, go bowling with us, go and go to the movies." And I really love you. I love you with all my heart. And I noticed that Maria, you just really are really supportive of Corey, financially, of course. No, but you are. I know you asked a lot of questions, and you really care about my family and me, and I really love you. So I wish you guys a really happy marriage, and I wish that you would just walk with God and see what he has for you guys. So God bless you.
Thanks for being here. Maria and I have always been close. We were the sisters you'd find holding hands and skipping through the yard, braiding each other's hair and making up clapping games. It's a sweet picture, isn't it? But that's not quite the total truth, unfortunately. At my wedding, Maria mentioned that I cried when I found out Mom was pregnant again. And people thought that was because I really wanted a sister, but I just wasn't ready to give up the title of baby, I guess. So, by the time I thought I made a really good baby. Anyway, then big-eyed and dark-haired Maria came along, energetic and ready to take all my things. But it was fun. I got to pick out her clothes and push her in my doll stroller, and I think she only fell out like once, maybe a couple times. But then we grew up, and 6 years is kind of a hard span on your sisters. We had some bumpy times, mostly my fault, I'm sure. Maybe we didn't skip hand in hand unless we were being chased. Maybe we only dressed alike when mom gave us no other choice. Maybe I only braided her hair because it was on my chore list. But we didn't know then that all that would one day change. When I went off to college, Maria just grew up, and she came to visit once, and I remember hugging her and going, oh my gosh, I miss you so much. And our friendship started those years. I'm so grateful it did. When Coley first came around, the family, we all knew that he was kind and funny and intelligent because Maria told us he was. We didn't actually know because the poor guy was shell-shocked. The first time he visited us, there were like 30 towels crammed in one house. It was summertime. I think Lindsay had just had a baby like the day before. And instead of eating the nice family, he was met with inside jokes, people eating more food than he had ever seen happen before, and a lot of noise. Our family's pretty loud. I'm pretty sure someone handed him a toddler and said, here, can you just hold this thing? And then all weekend long, he probably babysat between hearing Grandma Mills tell stories about her brothers in World War II. Remember Hunky and Wooly? We gave a really good first impression. Over time, Maria and Colby's relationship grew. It grew deep and strong. Maria would call me and tell me about this deep-thinking, hard-working guy that she was falling for, how he treated her so uniquely and she never felt more adored or understood or respected. I knew if Colby could handle Maria's 1,000-mile-an-hour pace, that he was probably a good fit for her. They have a friendship that is strong and deep. They care enough about each other to make sacrifices and put the other first. They meet the future with similar zeal and tenacity. They show that they want God to be there first, and have put their relationship on hold to pursue Him more fervently. Amen. They may only be about 12 years old, but they have mature souls beyond their years. Everyone in this room knows that their future will be unique, it will be powerful, and it will be a picture of God's creative blessings. If I could give you any marriage advice, it would be to work on your friendship, try out each other's hobbies, share what you think openly, and listen to the other, Maria. Have fun in the bedroom. Whoops. Serve your community together and pray for each other out loud. Marriage will test you. It will constantly measure the state of your heart. Is your heart kind? Is it loving? Is it selfless? Is it faithful and joyful? It will make you a better person if you let it. Embark on this journey with hearts open and let God take you where you've never been before together.
Amen.
Colby, Maria once told me that she wants to have more children than all of us, so I thought this was the right time to tell you. That's eating and breeding. Welcome to the family. Everybody raise your glass. May the two of you prosper for always.
Amen.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, for the first dance, his husband and the wife. We have a special song.
So Maria asked me to get creative tonight. I actually have a really slow rendition of Thunderstruck by AC/DC. So I hope you guys have about 11 minutes for me. Clearly that's a joke. Thank you.
Alright, run back up and get a picture with the bride with the bouquet.